Shalom, Paul Zajcik, founder of Elastic Seal, Method of Athletic Conditioning. Today I'm going to talk to you about the spinning back kick. I was going to do that video last week, however, when I announced that it's going to happen last week in the previous video before that, I got some questions about it. So I'm going to address two primary issues today. One, the back pain during the spinning back kick, and two, why there's a lack of power for a lot of people, lack of speed in the spinning back kick. Okay, real quick, lack of power, lack of speed. Everyone learned the spin back kick this way, right? In a fighting stance, footsteps here, turn, boom, kick, right? Okay, well, it's great when you learn that, okay? It's great that you find your balance, it's great that you turn, look at your target, find your target, you kick it, right? It's all nice. However, if you start breaking up the movements like that, as someone sent me the tape, and that's what it looks like, movements were great, everything was turned, heel was in line, everything was in line. But if you stop your movement, and spinning is a means to actually accelerate your mass into the target. It's not so much about the spin itself, it's what it does to your mass. So if you start breaking it up and stopping it here and there, of course you're going to lose speed, of course you're going to lose power. Very important to understand the difference here is between spinning back kick and spinning side kick. They're not the same thing, and they actually don't even look the same. Okay, spinning side kick is just another way to throw a side kick from a different position. So somebody turns pretty much, just turn like this, okay, from here, turn like this, throw the side kick. Okay, it's different than someone throwing a back kick. Okay, if you notice the line of my foot, one, it's parallel to the floor, two, it's at an angle, okay? So back kick is thrown this way, looking over the shoulder, but not completely turned. Back kick, in most cases, is a technique that you put a lot of power in, put up with the hands. Spinning side kick done correctly, it's much easier to follow up with the hands. But spinning side kick doesn't have the speed, doesn't have the surprise, and doesn't have the power of a spinning back kick. So you have to sort of, without doing this, and this, and this, and this, without doing all that, you sort of had to go boom. And that's what have to be learned. Okay, the same way as when you do a jump kick or a flying kick. You can break it up in certain ways, but after a while it has to be one complete kick, okay? The same thing here. All right? Spin back kick, notice difference. Spinning side kick would have been this. Okay, so that's one point. Second point is the injuries, okay? The way spin back kick is thrown is that although it's supposed to be at an angle, your foot is supposed to be at an angle, not this way, but this way, a lot of people do have a tendency to turn, okay? Now, when that happens, you have to have the rotation in your trunk, okay? So you're rotating from your trunk. Okay, notice the kick is behind me, I'm looking over, the rotation take from my spine, okay? If you rotate from your hips, you want that hip into the target, you don't want it away, okay? So the rotation is supposed to take place from the spine here. But, just to be safe, it's recommended to develop the flexibility in the hips, okay? So the feet are aligned. This is a very basic positioning, very similar to Warrior One. It's slightly different, okay? So instead of my bottom of my foot being on the floor, I put the inner edge on the floor, and I turn. Obviously, I can rotate this way, but I want to actually engage my hips a little bit, okay? Just to get that extra flexibility. Why? Because if I don't have that flexibility in the hips, primarily the adductors and hip flexors here, what's going to happen is I'm going to arch my back, okay, to compensate. I don't want that, so I actually want to move from the hip, okay? It's more difficult. You do this, you feel nothing. You do this, bring the hips forward, under you do that, a lot more difficult. However, practicing that stretch will actually guarantee you safer back. A lot of people do injure their back that way. And let's pull hip flexors and adductors, all right? So if you want to see more information about the kicking techniques, please take a look at the kicking combo. The link is below. And also, it's kicking certification coming up very shortly. Thank you for watching.
go this way. Good.